Hey guys, this is a continuation to our last video on iEnumerable and iEnumerator. Mostly I have seen developers not using iEnumerable directly in their code. But you know what? There are scenarios where using iEnumerable makes your code more efficient. We will learn how to make our code more efficient using iEnumerable. Of course, in certain specific scenarios. This will be a short video. Let's get started. Usually, whenever we have to use a collection, we use mostly list or dictionary, whether as a return type or for storing some related data. But as mentioned, there are scenarios where explicitly using iEnumerable of T can make your code more efficient and improve performance. Let me walk you through an existing code which does not use iEnumerable of T explicitly. So I have this iRepository interface with two methods, getStudentByAge and getStudentByGender. Both returns list of student, and implemented iRepository to repository class. We have a list of student here. Student is a model class up here. Added few student to the list and implemented our method. This is a link query, and since method return type is list, I have converted the result of link query to list. Similarly converted here as well. Up here I have a kind of facade class. If you want to know more about facade class, watch my video on facade design pattern. You can find the link in the description. It has mainly two methods, getStudentByAge and getStudentByGender. It just delegates the call to our repository, gets the data and returns back. Now let's see our calling code. We get the age from the user, then instantiate our facade and get the student by age by calling our facade method, and then display all the students that our facade returns. Then down here it gets the gender from the user and similarly calls the facade method to get all the students with the given gender. And if there are no students with given gender, then we add one. And finally display all the students. Let me run and show you if this code works. So let's give age as 16. So we get all the students having age 16. That's Julie and Mark. Let's give gender as male. So we get all the students except Julie. So the code is working fine. Now let's come back to our code and see if we can optimize it. Note that both the methods in our facade returns list of students. And what do we do with the return values? For student by age, we just loop through the list and display items. And for student by gender, we put a check first. If the list contains zero student, then we go ahead and add one student to it. And this piece of code displays the student. All looks fine, right? Where is the inefficiency? That's here. The conversion of the return value to list. Actually, we should never convert to any type unless we require to do so. Hence, it is always advisable if link query returns iEnumerable, then try to return the same. Unless you are using some methods of that converted type. Now if you see getStudentByAge, which returns a list of student, which we just loop through. For this, basically iEnumerable is sufficient. Let's make the code change. Perhaps will be much easier to understand. Let me change our interface method signature to iEnumerable. Accordingly, change the return type of the implemented method. And since our where clause by default returns iEnumerable, so we do not need any conversion now. So we can safely remove this to list. Also, let's change our facade method return type. That's it. Let's go to our program class. See, no compile time error. It still works fine. That's because we are anyway not using the additional features that list provides. And just for looping and displaying data, iEnumerable is sufficient. so the additional conversion to list can be definitely avoided. Let me run and see. See, it all works fine. But now, can we make the similar changes to other method as well? Let's do that and see. So, IEnumerable down here as well. Remove the conversion. Let's change the facade method as well. Now let's go to our program class and see. See, it immediately shows a compile time error. IEnumerable of student does not contain a definition for add. The error method says very clearly where the problem is. The add method is available in list and not in IEnumerable. And right now, this is an IEnumerable. So, for this scenario, we must convert it to list. But again, it is good to convert as late as possible. I mean, when you need it, then you convert and use it. So maybe I can convert it here. See, our compiler error is gone. Let me run. 16, mail. So all works fine. Now this is more efficient code. So the summary is, avoid conversion to list or to dictionary unless you are using the additional functions provided by these collections. I hope next time when you code, you will consider this. That's all for this video. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and drop in your comments for all the future videos on C# and other technologies. Thanks.